Hello, everybody. My name is Valerio Virgillito, and I'm an engineer on the Google Web Designer team. Today, I want to spend a little bit of time talking about the tag tool. As the name implies, the tag tool allows you to interactively create an HTML element and then insert it into your document. So let's take a look on how to actually add an HTML element to our existing document. First, we must select the tag tool. We go over to the tool list and simply click on the tag tool. Then simply click and drag the mouse across the stage to set the initial position and dimension of your HTML element, and then release the mouse button, and there you have it. I just inserted an HTML div element inside of my document. By default, Google Web Designer tag tool will insert div elements into your document. But we are not limiting to only creating div elements. In fact, the tag tool can visually create every single valid HTML element as well as custom elements. So let's take a look. So after selecting the tag tool, I can now change which type of HTML element I would like to create. Here in the tool options on the top, you can see that by default, I have the div element selected. But if I click on the next one, the image element, and now do the same steps as before, the element that gets inserted into my document is actually an image element, as you can see from the label up here. And the same as with the image, I can just as easily create a video element or click on the custom elements and get an input field where I can type the element I would like to create. This input field has autocomplete turned on so that it is easier to actually find and type the element that you would like to create. As you can see, you can choose to create a new section element or maybe a footer element or any other valid HTML5 element. Now, on top of selecting which element type you would like to insert into your document, we also allow a couple more properties to be set before inserting a new element: background color and border radiuses. So let's go back and select our div element right here. And now, instead of creating a transparent or a div with no background color, I'm going to click on this color chip button and pick any color I want. Let's pick some red here. And then I also want to add some border radiuses on this div element I'm about to insert. Now, by default, when changing the border radius, it will apply to all four borders. And now, as you can see, when I'm inserting a new div into my document, div element into my document, it will have a red background color and a very small border radius. Since it's really hard to see, let me insert another div element in my document. This time, let's pick a bigger border radius. And as you can see now, it's much more visible. Now, the last thing I wanted to show is that if you click on this lock icon right here, you can now individually choose the amount of border that you want to have on each of the four corners. So for this example, I'm going to change the color. I want to pick a radial gradient for the background color, like so. And then just change some of the values here for a few of the for some of the border radiuses. And now when I insert a div element into my document, as you can see, I've applied a radial gradient to the background and different border radiuses for each of the four borders. And that's it for the tag tool. Thank you very much.